Yeah, I'm ready, but I think you should edit out the part where you say that you bootleg. That is illegal.
I was gonna edit it out. Maybe.
Funny.
I'll take on the internet.
Okay, I'm ready.
All right. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, start. All that animation. So beautiful.
I have so much nostalgia.
I have not seen this in years.
Neither have I.
You haven't even seen this at all.
I'm talking about the show.
Oh, crap.
Why isn't there any sound?
Oh, this. I do remember this. This is how it's supposed to open.
Oh, okay. I was fixing to say, is something wrong with the video?
Because I'm about to say a little background. This takes place at the very end of the TV show. It's dark because you'll see in a second.
That's what that's kind of what I know, but didn't they make like a movie after this, like a Christmas movie?
That was during the actual TV show. That was way before this. They had
Oh, okay.
a Christmas special, a Halloween special, and a Valentine's Day special.
Yeah.
You're wondering why it's so silent, but you're gonna see in a few seconds. They're just building up suspense.
Ants.
Yep. That's not the worst of it.
Oh, what the?
Yup. Yup.
What the heck?
Oh my God.
What did?
Okay, so the synopsis for this was apparently the ad this is another one another one of their scams. Apparently they pulled off a scam that was so terrible that all the kids are after them for real this time. So they have to,
What did they
yeah,
do?
that's the thing, they never explain it, they never tell you, it's left to your imagination. Damn it.
It couldn't have been that bad.
It apparently was. You saw what happened to that dude's house?
Yeah.
Ed, just use your hand. Jesus Christ.
This is stupid even for you, Ed.
I love the music. Jesus. All that effort for one
Is he?
sock. Yeah, so.
What? He's using that like a hobo bag?
Apparently. I remember that one episode when they found a chicken in that chair.
Now, I do have a question.
Yeah.
Do the parents know about this or what?
The parents don't even show up in this show. There was one episode when they show up and you
Yeah,
don't even see their
with like their
faces.
hands.
Yeah.
But again, they are mentioned though.
Yeah. But yeah, apparently they never do explain. Oh, I hated Jimmy as a kid. I hated Jimmy. I'm sorry. I wanted to punch him.
Yeah, I was the kid who got beaten up, and even I wanted to beat him up.
It's like in South Park when they turned the fifth graders and the sixth graders would beat him up. And then they mess with
Yeah.
fourth graders.
Yeah.
I really wanted to punch Jimmy though. Except there was that one episode where he tricked the Eds. Because he stole like those jujubes or something.
Yeah. Now, Ed, pack light.
He wouldn't even know what the word light means. Or pack.
True.
But you see what I mean? They're so scared they're packing up and leaving.
Yeah, but Double D, you need the pack light as well.
The man's writing a poem.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez! He's got an old stack of paper.
OCD, really?
They confirmed in the show he has OCD.
Yeah.
I remember when they used to
Oh,
put
come
sticky
on,
notes
the
all over
H
his
is not
house.
perfect.
True. One of the biggest rumors, like, how old are these kids?
I was thinking like 12.
Yeah, I was thinking 12 or 13.
Yet, I think they're going to elementary school, aren't they? Or middle school?
Yeah, they're like in sixth grade.
Yeah.
I remember there was a cartoon theory I watched a while ago where it was like the kids in the cul-de-sac are actually in purgatory because they can never leave the cul-de-sac.
Yeah, but they leave the cul-de-sac, don't they? I think that's what this one
Yeah.
was about.
Yeah, in the movie, but I'm talking about back when the show first started, 'cause like, because
I remember that theory, and that's what they said that debunked it. Debunked it.
yeah, like a parent, and of course we have Eddie.
Oh.
Damn.
Oh.
What? Ooh.
Can't they just tell their parents what's happening and ask them to move?
I don't think their parents really care, considering they'll ask their parents for help at all.
They don't care if their kids get maimed.
Did he really think that was gonna work? I remember I had the game to this. Pretty
Yeah.
good. He always says
Eddie,
that.
you're acting like you killed somebody.
That's why I really like this like opening scene. It showed them at their most scared, and what really kills me is that you have no idea what they did.
Yeah, they never show like flashbacks or anything.
No, I've seen this movie before, and I remember they only show you that one scene. You have to imagine what they did.
And who says it was really them? Maybe it was just a freak accident.
Obviously, they know it was them. They're the only ones that do scams.
True, but I mean, what if the scam wasn't the cause?
I'm
What
sorry,
if
the
the
wall got
scam?
me.
True, but what if the scam wasn't the cause of whatever they did? What if it was just a freak accident and they happened to be there?
Even if it was a freak accident, you know they'd always be blamed. Jesus, look, they already bust down
True.
the door. This is a scary scene, though. They're just running for their lives.
In the show, did you ever just want to buy the three a jawbreaker so they would
Yeah.
just stop?
I actually wanted one of those jawbreakers because I actually thought jawbreakers were that big as a kid. Then I got one, I was like, the hell is this?
They do come that big.
No, I mean in the show, like they were like fill up their jaw. Is there a piece of toast
Yeah,
on his
no,
back?
yeah, now Gobstoppers come that big.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, that wallpaper would be awesome if it actually looked real.
Yeah.
I remember the brothers' room. That was in the show a lot.
Yeah.
They found the map to like treasure. Turned out it led to the Kanker's basement.
Yeah, how old were the Kanker sisters anyway?
That's a weird one for me because it's
I was thinking like maybe 16.
then that would mean they're pedophiles.
No, if the Eds are 13, they're only like 3 years older.
Oh, yeah, true. I was thinking if they were 17, yeah.
Yeah.
But I always found it weird because, like, obviously, every one of the fans, when you watch this again, it's like, how many times have the Kankers actually raped the Eds?
Yeah, and they do look older, don't they?
That's why I was always confused. I'll never forget that one episode where Double D's like mowing his lawn and he finds the lipstick on the ground. He's like, how peculiar. His eyes open up. He's like, oh my. He starts looking around. And he gets jumped.
Boys, what did those girls do to you?
Ed, you idiot. Oh, they're doomed.
Yeah.
I'm so. I like.
What?
That was in the show. I remember that. His brother's an ass.
Leave Ed there.
I wish that would have worked. That would have been funny. Jesus.
Yes, but they should just leave Ed there. He'll be a liability.
They should just have Ed punch everybody.
Or have Ed put the monster costume back on.
I don't even think they have it in there. That would work too. In the game, they gave Ed the ability. They give each Ed special abilities, and Ed's was that the other two turn him into a battering ram. That's what they should have done in this. A peanut.
Wait, did they just break the fourth wall?
Yeah.
God, what happened to their arm?
Look at it. There's a mouse trap on his finger. I told you they were mad.
Yeah.
Wait.
How?
We don't ask questions about Ed.
True.
I'm wondering how you get a car in that room. What happened to Ness?
I thought that was his bed for a minute.
Okay.
But, like, one of those old race car beds?
Yeah. Okay, this is the best part of the
movie.
But it's
actually a real car?
No, you'll see in a minute, but this is the best part. Oh, God, Rolf looks mad.
Yeah.
Look at his head!
Yeah,
Look at Johnny!
Yeah, it looks like someone took a bite out of Rolf.
Look at Ed. Here we go.
Flintstones.
Yup. Look at this.
And Dukes of Hazzard.
It's Fast and Furious 8. And they're gone.
I thought that even though they did scams, they were still friends.
What, with the other kids?
Yes.
Not sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, I think even
it was really
Kevin was nice to them at one point.
It's really Kevin and Sarah that hate them. The others hate them when they like mess with them.
Yeah, I think Naz is like the nicest out of all of them.
Yeah, look, they're just gone.
It's and even
I'm sorry, it's Wacky Racers with the Eds.
How are Sarah and Jimmy not affected by this? I mean, what did they do to Plank?
Like I said, you have no idea. And Jimmy and Sarah have no idea what's going on. Look at Jimmy! Is that a bear trap on his head?
Which is weird, because aren't they usually in the scam, too? I mean...
Sometimes. It looked like someone took a bite out of Wolf's chest.
Did anyone feel sorry that Ed had a little sister like that?
Yeah.
Ooh. Like Sarah?
Oh, they got Ed!
Oh, God.
That look it hurts. Save yourselves.
Save him?
This is the most heroic Ed's ever been. No, they got him. They can't leave him.
This is the most heroic Eddie's ever been.
They can't leave Ed. Oh my God, that look like it hurts. His ankle should be broken.
I'm surprised Eddie didn't actually mention, let's just leave him.
This is their most desperate because you can tell Eddie's being a good guy. Hey, it's the graveyard. I mean, good graveyard. The dumpster.
Yeah. And you can actually tell Eddie cares about his friends.
Yep. Oh, there goes Kevin. Look at his hat.
What did they do to Naz?
Naz is so far behind. She can't even go nowhere else with the skates.
I didn't even know Naz could get angry.
Is that Jimmy's brain? I mean, Johnny's?
No. His head is in a bear trap.
It looked like his brain, though. Is he really trying to ram the one with his bike? Really, Kevin?
Come on, they're running away. Just leave him alone.
I like how in the show, especially, whenever Kevin came up with his bike, that always made it sound like a motorcycle.
Yeah, what playing cards did he put in it?
No idea. This is when I first played GTA. I just spin around. Oh my God, that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God, Eddie. He has to have rug burn for weeks.
Yeah. I'm surprised their parents won't be worried when they're gone.
I'm surprised. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
Especially Double D's parents, because aren't they overprotective?
Apparently. I'm glad this action scene went on as long as it did. This is pretty cool. It's like, hold on.
Yeah, but if Double D's parents are so overprotective, why do they let him hang out with Ed and Eddy?
Because he knows that they can't make other friends. Oh, God.
Yeah. True. Did you know that there's a theory that...
Hold on, Rolf turned into Sonic. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, did you know that there's a theory that Double D doesn't really have parents and he just writes the notes himself?
Oh, yeah. That's depressing.
Yes.
Oh, my God. This is better than the Fast and Furious movies.
But that would explain why supposedly overprotective parents would let their son get in all these scams and everything.
Yeah. There are a lot of conspiracy theories with this show.
Yeah.
Why don't they just jump in and get them already? They're waiting.
Oh, come on. That would be the sensible one. I think they wouldn't believe that, would they?
Look how awesome Double D gets. Watch this.
Yeah, but isn't Double D actually the one with the conscience?
Yeah. He tries to stop them in every scam, but they always seem to pull him out.
Yeah, now, let me see. I think, what would they have done if Double D was just there if he had actually just apologized? Since he's been known to be the one to, you know, actually feel sorry and apologize afterwards. They probably would have killed Ed and Eddy, but I don't know about Double D.
Here's the funny thing. See, they always say what they did and stuff like that, but they never mention what it is.
Yeah.
Look at her hair.
Yeah.
But with there was an episode where they explained how Ed and Eddy met. Apparently, Ed and Eddy already knew each other, and Double D had just moved into the neighborhood.
Yeah.
So I'm guessing it's because Ed and Eddy are are some of his real friends, considering they were the first ones he made when he moved in.
Yeah. Now,
yeah, they're gone. So,
yeah.
In the movie, they don't just stay in the cul-de-sac or in the construction yard or the junkyard. They go to new locations. Places you never saw in the show.
Yes, but where are they going exactly?
Oh, you'll find out soon. You want to know, I love that chase scene in the car, but you want to know what made it better?
What?
If they used that car from the show, the one with the mattress in the back.
Oh, yeah.
That would have been perfect.
One. Yeah.
Sarah's an ass. She's like, if we could get to them, we can watch.
Does she really hate her brother that much?
Apparently. Look where they got launched.
Wasn't there like one episode where Sarah was actually nice to her older brother?
It was because of that boomerang that was going around.
Yeah. I'm like, can't they just give her the boomerang and like glue it to her?
I remember the boomerang, but in the end of the episode, the three Eds get stuck in that tree with the boomerang and they can't like get down. And that's how it ends.
Yeah, but apparently they got down.
Ooh, that had to hurt. The car explodes.
Ah, that looks like it hurt.
All of this looks like it hurt.
Yeah. These boys are durable.
Yeah. Just like Danny Phantom, this show actually got an official end. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
I'm glad he got an official ending.
Yeah.
And I was doing research on this when
that
I checked.
That looks like the boomerang symbol, doesn't it?
It does. I think I had boomerang. Ooh.
Yeah.
He should be dead. He landed face first.
They all should be dead.
True.
Technically. Because didn't Eddy just fall apart into like a million pieces?
Yeah. See, obviously he's having the conscience. He's raving about how they went too far.
Yeah. I never got why their tongues were like blue and green.
I always thought it was because they ate too many Jawbreakers and it changed their colors.
Yeah.
You know the rumor about the hat on his head?
That he has cancer?
Yeah, and that he's bald.
Yeah, and that he has a scar, but didn't he take the hat off in one episode?
Yeah, but you still don't see what it is.
True. They should have taken the hat off in this episode so we could see.
I can't remember. I remember them taking the hat off, but I don't know if you see it. I can't remember.
Yeah, but I mean, in this movie, I think they should so we could see. How many seasons were there?
Six or seven.
Okay.
This was Cartoon Network's actually longest running cartoon. I remember.
And now SpongeBob blew that title away.
Yeah, because this started in 99, and the movie didn't air until 2009. This was on for 10 years.
Yeah, and SpongeBob's been on for like what, 20 years?
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, this is the longest running Cartoon Network show still. The other show's beaten this. I'm thinking Adventure Time might beat it though.
Yeah, I think Teen Titans came close, didn't it?
Yeah, Teen Titans was on for like 6 years. How does he always
Yeah,
got
it
stuff under
came
that
pretty
hat?
close. I don't know.
Oh,
Out of.
remember that. Remember
Really,
that.
Double D?
Remember that, okay?
Really?
Remember that he puts that stuff down.
Yeah. Yeah, but really, Double D?
Hey.
I think people could tell it's out of order.
Hey, he's a kleptomaniac. What do you expect?
True. He's OCD, not a kleptomaniac.
Oh, and yeah, wrong word. Look,
He doesn't steal the car.
I don't know my scientific forms, okay?
Johnny, I think you might need to go to the hospital.
Isn't it funny that Johnny's the only one that actually have a last name in this whole show?
What's his last name again?
2x4?
Oh, yeah.
Is he Batman? He's got a secret lair.
Yeah.
I forgot it. Yeah, you're gonna see who this is soon. You probably remember who this is.
Melon Man?
Melon
Or
Man?
something?
I think it was Captain Melonhead.
Yeah, Captain Melonhead.
I can't remember who Plank was, though.
I thought
Where?
he was like Stump or something.
Stump! What the heck?
He's had this in
How?
that tree this whole time.
And think about it. Since that first episode when he was in it,
Yeah.
he hasn't been Captain Melonhead since. This is his
And those are
return.
real watermelons.
Oh my God.
Splinter the Wonderwood.
Oh, that's what it was. Why is he on a mop? Melon vision.
I think this is making fun of the 1960s Batman.
Wouldn't his eyes be burning if he's touching that part of the watermelon?
I don't know, but this is making fun of the 1960s Batman.
How do you think? Melon
Well, the
vision.
campiness and what they're saying.
True. I still think this show's timeless because, like, you can't
Yeah,
tell what
true.
time period this is in.
Yeah, true. I was thinking early 90s.
You could, but you can also say it was the 2000s. Like, it's not like anything they're wearing wouldn't be worn today. All those flies, Jesus.
True. True, and they don't really have cell phones or anything in the show, do they?
No, they don't have cell phones, they have TV.
But they don't have computers either.
Maybe they
Well,
did. I can't remember. Maybe in the school seasons?
yeah,
Ooh.
and ooh. But the TVs range from like really nice to really old ones.
Yeah.
So you don't really know.
Oh, I love this scene.
Yeah, it really his bike.
I love that scene.
It's just a bike.
I like how they've been hinting at a Naz and Kevin relationship for the whole show, This is the only time when it actually comes into play. Even though there were episodes where he clearly did like Naz.
Kevin, it's gone.
See, they always mention, I'm sorry, they always mention what they did, but they don't tell you.
Yeah.
Jeez. Is Kevin being a detective now? Because he's being really smart.
Wait, are they? Are we going to meet Eddie's brother?
Yes, that was the big thing about this movie.
An actual adult?
Yep. See? And remember,
Cool.
there's an episode when you meant when they mention his brother, and they're all scared of him.
Yeah. Yet they don't seem scared of him here, do they?
No, they're scared of him. That's why Kevin's in a rush. Look at him.
Yeah.
You didn't hear
Oh,
it, but
yeah.
because he pieced together that they're going to his brother's house, and they're like, we gotta get to them before they do.
What is he very overprotective of Eddie or something?
Yeah, they're scared of Eddie's brother because he's infamous for being like a bad person, so that's why they're scared if he gets there first.
Plus, in protecting his brother, I guess, too.
Yeah. But you'll see what I mean by the end.
Rolf, what are you wearing?
I'm wondering why he has wool for carry all that stuff.
Don't know.
That was always a theory that people had. What country is he from?
I was thinking like maybe Switzerland.
He
Weren't you?
was ready with a rake, but yeah, I was thinking Switzerland, but then his skin tone. I'm not trying to be racist, but I don't think Rolf's skin tone would be very prevalent in Switzerland.
Farmers.
True. I'm just thinking he just looks tan.
True, but I have a friend whose parents are from Switzerland and they're tan.
Maybe it was Switzerland. Wait, what's that language? I'll decode that later. I want to figure out what that language is. It's probably made up.
It might be Latin.
You know what? It did look Latin. What the heck? It looks like Cyclops glasses if it was made in the 30s.
Rolf, I didn't,
Is that a car engine?
Yeah. Is he cooking an egg on it?
Apparently, inspecting an egg will help him. Wait, what'd that say?
Well, I don't even want to know what that is.
He's like Batman. He's analyzing the crime scene.
I don't even want to know what's in that canteen, do you?
No, I tried to leave the label, but I couldn't.
The label had his name on it.
Oh, that's what it was? I
Yeah.
saw the R. I didn't know if it was his name. Okay.
I don't want to know what that yellow stuff is.
Looks like honey.
Well, it came out of a canteen.
Oh my God. He's intelligent.
Yeah, did he just make himself some lunch?
Technically, he did. Oh my God, that was funny. I still love this show, even after all these years.
I think Wilfred is the smartest one out of all of
I thought Plank was the smartest.
them. Well,
Hey, look at his back.
Wilfred.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, well, Wilfred is the second smartest.
Babs, check it out. Oh God.
Jeez, Rolf.
See, that's why I told you to remember that. That's how they hit the fall one. Okay, now they're in the field.
What happened to Ed's shoe again?
Remember he was taking off his sock?
Oh, yeah. And he never put his shoe back on?
It's Ed. I'd be surprised if he put on his underwear.
True.
Private property? Like they care.
Dude, it's either that or
get
the
beat up.
kids. Yeah, it's either get shot at or get beat up. Choose.
I'm surprised. Look at it!
Look at all those cows.
Man.
Oh.
Ooh. Ooh.
I seriously think they don't have any bones.
It would make a lot of sense. The funny thing about it, when I did a lot of research on this show back when it like first ended. Apparently the creator of this show, he's more known for adult themed cartoons.
Yeah, no. Is Eddie's brother rich or something?
No. I guess he's just mean.
No, I mean Eddie just said that his brother has like 100 cows.
Well, remember, if Eddie is learning from his brother's probably much of a liar as he is.
True.
Because Eddie being mean, his brother, like, you'll know when you see the ending, but when you see his brother, you'll see why Eddie is the way he is.
Yeah.
He has no idea where they're going. But yeah, apparently.
How does he not know where his brother lives?
Wait, what? How do you expect Double D to figure that out? With no evidence.
Plus, you're his brother. You should know where he lives.
I mean, Double D's smart. Did he teleport? How did he get up there?
I don't know.
Why don't you say whereabouts? Like, he even knows what that word means. I don't know why you're so chill about this. You have the entire neighborhood after you.
And Double D even seems scared of his brother, don't you?
Yeah.
Don't you think?
Okay, this is how they figure it out. How do they both fit in that one coat?
It's Ed's coat. Don't question it.
You're right. He's so cheap. Oh! He should have passed out.
Yeah. Well, if he didn't pass out, that means that Ed actually cleaned himself up a little.
There needs to... They
get
should
it?
I know. I was trying to think. But yeah. I was thinking the creator of this show went on... Like I said, he done adult cartoons, and they're, like, really violent. This show was a dare. They dared him to make a kid's cartoon that would work. And this is what he came up with.
Yeah.
I forgot about his insane super strength.
Yeah.
Wow. Facial hair stink bomb. I like how they reference the other episodes. Why does he hang out with them? Seriously.
Yeah, I can get why he hangs out with Egg, because Ed seems a little bit nice.
Yeah. I like how Ed actually came up with a good lead.
Yeah, is he feeling okay?
But I like how Double D actually pieced it together. It made sense. Like, he's always been doing these jokes that got them in trouble. The hot sauce. The stink bomb that they made. The freaking treasure
probably map. Probably this scam.
Yeah, I'm sorry, but this movie really gets to me because they actually talk about previous episodes.
Yeah.
Because every time a new episode starts, I always assume, like, the other episodes never happened, so they forget.
Yeah, now, they really made Sarah malicious in this.
Yeah. Did you always, this was the theory I had, did you always think that Jimmy and Sarah were dating or that Jimmy was gay?
Man, I always thought that Jimmy was gay.
I heard people say, I always heard people say that he was gay. That's what I thought too.
Yeah.
And that he was now, a wuss.
Yes, now.
Oh, God.
I know that Sarah hates her brother, but I know that in past episodes, even she wouldn't even resort to this.
You know where they are, right?
Yes, I do. That's why I said that even she wouldn't resort to this.
Oh, I thought you meant like Chase. Oh, God. He's doomed. If I was him, I would hide until they weren't looking and run. Damn.
Are they like friends or sisters?
They're sisters. They call them the Canker Sisters.
True, but
I think they're all, I remember in the show, like, I think they're all stepsisters, though. Like, they all have the same mom.
But a different dad.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, or they could just be a gang called the Canker Sisters.
They're a gang. Jimmy, you should just run. Oh, he's doomed.
Uh-oh.
Oh, he is so doomed.
Jimmy, run, boy, run.
He wouldn't know how to run.
Or call for Sarah. Call for Sarah.
That reminded me. There was that one episode where they parked their trailer on top of Eddie's lawn. And they steal plank. Johnny sneaks in and he beats them up and steals plank back.
Yeah.
He was. And I remember May's like, give me back my back scratcher. Scratch this.
Yeah.
He says the flying.
Yeah, no one messes with plank.
We gotta watch that episode. Yeah. Is that a bra? I think this is the worst Jimmy's been.
Yeah, I think that was a bra. Why would they need that?
They're gonna turn him Mr. Fantastic.
Again, why would the girls need those bras?
I feel like they were interrogating him.
Where were you?
Apparently she came back from the woods. Even she can't take on the canker. Oh.
Uh-oh.
Even she can't take on all three of them. I like
Oh, good God. No,
oh,
no, no, no.
No, 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 no. I remember this book.
Come on, she's just a little girl.
I'm about to throw up, actually. Oh, God, no. Not in here.
Come on, she's just a little girl.
Oh.
First time I've ever felt sorry for Sarah.
I'm about to throw up, actually. That's terrible. Oh, Jesus, I forgot. And now the Kinkers are involved in the chase.
Probably to save them.
Yeah. Okay. What? Wait, what?
Yeah.
That's abusive. I ever heard it.
Yeah.
So now we officially start the plot.
Wait, which one did she like?
Was
it Double D or Ed? Because I know the red-haired one liked Eddie.
You're right. The orange-haired one is Lee. She liked Eddie.
Yeah.
Marie was the blue-haired one, and she was with Ed. And the dumb blonde was May. She was with freaking Ed.
Double D.
No, I switched it. Marie was with Double D. Ed was with the blonde.
Yeah, I was fixing to say, shouldn't they be switched since their personalities do kind of coincide?
Mm-hmm. What the heck? It looks like a lion.
I seriously do think that May, the blonde,
May and Ed are both retarded, so they do belong together.
Yeah, I think they're perfect for each other if she wouldn't try to hurt him.
Mm-hmm. Or rape him.
Yeah.
And
Whoa.
wow, that'd be cool as a weapon if you know where to use it.
Oh.
Oh my god. Oh! It's like one of those Nightwing sticks that he spins around. I think he cut off his head. Gotcha, Eddie. I thought he said sex for a minute.
What were they eating? They're not really going there, are
I
they?
think Eddie even picked it up. I can't remember. I don't know if this came out in theaters. I don't think so. A sex
Ed
tape.
even picked it up.
I didn't think Ed would know what that word even means. Even Double D's thinking, he's like, what are they laughing for? He just figured it out. He just figured it out.
Yeah.
How would they know about porn? Wait, never mind, they're 13.
Yeah. And in an episode, didn't Eddie have some magazines
Oh
underneath his
yeah.
bed?
Yeah, porno mag. They he went right to the wall.
Oh.
They get abused a lot in this movie.
Yeah, more than they do in the whole show.
Okay, they made it to the factory that they talked about.
True, but it's closed down, isn't it?
Look like it. Look how decrepit it is.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously I'm a fan, so I'm enjoying this, but I really did like the fact that they actually did make new locations for the show. I mean, for the
Yeah,
movie.
it would have been funny if inside it was like Wonka's Chocolate Factory, only it was
Jawbreakers.
only it was like joke themed.
Oh my god. I imagine I wanted it because it I already know what it's gonna look like because I do remember some parts of this, but I
Yeah.
wish it was a Jawbreaker factory that got closed down.
Yeah. Yeah, I bet they would just stay there, don't you? Did is that pig trying to eat sausage?
Yep.
That is just weird.
That is a lot of things. I swear, Rolf is probably the smartest one in this episode. He's finding all these clues.
And I think he's just trying to do his chores too.
Like, look, he's closer than anybody else is.
Yes, but Wilbur's the one helping him.
I know, but I'm talking about like when it comes to actually like tracking them down, he's the closest.
Yep, there's a clue.
See? That's what I mean. He's always finding these clues. The
That's a
characters.
fat cow.
Okay, so I'm trying to think. We have at least four teams. We have the Eds. We have Rolf and Wilfred, Naz and Kevin, and then we have Jimmy, Sarah, and the Canker Sisters.
And let's not forget Captain
Oh yeah, we have
Melonhead.
Johnny and Plank. That's five
Yeah.
teams.
Who will get to him first?
I think it's Rolf. He's the closest. Heck, we have no idea where Johnny is,
True,
and
but
go, oh, I'm sorry.
yeah.
I'm sorry.
But apparently in this show everyone can teleport. 'Cause in previous shows it seems like they could teleport, doesn't it?
Yeah. And sometimes I you can't even tell how long this is taking them to go. Like in the beginning they were in the desert. How long is this? It seems like it's the same day.
Yeah, I mean, shouldn't their parents be calling the cops by now?
I think that's probably why it turns out that they weren't actually gone for that long. It's only been a few hours.
Yeah, because normally their parents would be calling the cops by now, probably.
Well, then again, there were episodes where it was the middle of summer and they were out like late at night.
True, but they never left the cul-de-sac, though.
True.
And I'm sure their parents were within yelling distance.
Yeah. I imagine if they would have got another season, they would have done more episodes in each other locations. Like, I imagine them doing a scam in that factory.
Yeah, but imagine if they do a reboot where they're all grown up.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
They're still doing scams, but it's adult-themed scams? Ooh.
Yeah. Yeah, and Eddy is actually successful.
I imagine Eddy's still living in his parents'
but
house.
But with the way, the things are going, the reboots are going, they'll probably make Ed smart, Double D stupid, and Eddy, they'll probably make him nice.
If there was a reboot, I imagine this is how it would be. Like, Double D is the smartest one, like, but somehow he turns into a teacher. Eddie's obviously going to be the less successful one. He ends up, like, I don't know, owning an apartment building or something.
Yeah, and Ed?
I imagine Ed, like, wins the lottery and he becomes rich. Wait, was he a hot dog?
Imagine if Ed is actually smart when he grows up.
Yeah. I just imagine that he, like, had $1 million.
Yeah. And Sarah's actually nice to him. Because of the money, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Did you notice when he was shocking Eddy, he turned into his Viking outfit?
Yeah.
In some of the other costumes?
Yeah, and he even turned old from that episode that was a flashback.
Yeah. They even had that one episode where he was the mascot for their middle school.
Yeah.
Like I said, this is clearly just a fan letter to the entire show.
Yeah, wait,
personnel.
There was probably a chair, like, right off screen, yet he still...
I imagine, like, the filing cabinet will fall over.
Yeah.
Because the weight's not shifting properly.
Yeah.
Stop leaving clues, damn it.
Yeah, I'm surprised they're not beating up Double D for doing this.
Well, then again, Eddy led them to the field. He had his... No, that was Ed.
Yeah. Eddie's done nothing but run for his life.
This would be scary to live in, though. Ooh.
Yeah,
I just thought about
where'd
it.
Where'd they go?
The wolf got to him.
Yeah.
I told you he was the closest. Yeah.
True.
This is generally horrifying.
Movie over. They all die. The end.
I imagine, like, the Ninja Turtles having a base here. Oh, we gotta watch the Turtles movies.
Which ones?
The 90s ones?
The original three or that new,
the original
or
three.
The animated one?
The original three.
Okay.
We'll get to the others later, but I love the original three.
Yeah. Though Splinter kind of looked creepy in those.
Except the third one. The third one was awful.
Yeah, did you see how creepy Splinter looked in those?
Yes. He looked like a hairball.
Did you see the Ninja Turtles Christmas musical?
Oh, God. Thing? I did a riff of that, but I deleted it because it ended up being terrible. We have to riff that.
Yeah, we do.
I like how they're pranking him.
Yeah. So sorry, I keep coughing.
It's okay.
Where I am, it's really humid and dusty.
Humid. I'm not judging. It's all right. Why does it sound like a?
I'm judging. I'm supposed to be an English major.
Why does it sound like a can of Pringles when he opened it?
I don't know, but how many snakes were in there?
Oh, now Kevin and Naz are catching up.
It would be funny if Johnny actually got to them first.
Oh, God. Look how close they are.
Yes, but it would be funny if Johnny actually got to them first.
Oh, it would be. What kills me is they stop and goof around at every station. It's like, why would you stop? Keep going.
Stop. Find what you need to get to his house, then keep going. Right?
Is he gonna beat him with the shoe?
Yeah, probably.
Wilford knows.
I think he's been beaten with that shoe before, don't you?
Yeah. He's beating him bad too. You want to have been funnier?
What?
If this was Victor?
Yeah, it would be funny.
Like, I imagine, if this was really, I would have had Rolf, like, had an entourage. It was all of his animals.
Yeah, Victor's the goat, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Yep. Oh, no. Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh. Is he in a cheese grater?
No, he's in a meat grinder.
Oh, God, I didn't notice.
Oh. Oh, God.
I'm sorry, this is funny. Ooh.
Rolf, go to the hospital.
They all need to be in the hospital.
Yeah.
Dang, all those snakes. Shut up, Ed. You sound bored.
No, I was just thinking, why would he keep talking when he knows that they're close behind?
They have no idea how far they are.
True, but yet they don't stop.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad they didn't make this movie, like, way too serious. It's still funny like it's supposed to be.
Yes, I still want to know what they did, though.
I remember the creator, they had an interview with him, and he's like, we never intended to let the audience know what they truly did. You were supposed to examine the first scene and figure it out on your own.
All I saw is that they killed somebody.
I saw, like, a car getting reared off, somebody's house getting just, how do you end up up there?
Yeah, but I want to know, is the whole gang there? Because if someone got hurt or killed, that would make sense.
How'd he even get up there?
I don't know. Oh, no, he's going to have to get rid of the hat, isn't he?
Maybe. My question...
Or not.
Oh, that'd be terrifying.
That would be fun.
What if there was no ground? Wait, was that treasure?
Yeah, that was pirate treasure. They could have just got that up and gave that to the kids.
Remember the treasure map episode?
Yeah, but...
It turns out they read the treasure map wrong. That was the actual treasure right there.
Yeah. Yeah, that would be funny. Oh, that looks like it hurts.
Yeah. Is his upper lip stuck in his buck tooth?
Yep.
Oh, that was easy.
Yeah.
Oh, Will. He's a fat-ass liar.
I have a feeling he might actually be telling the truth about that one.
The blubber?
Or the no, the whale what? Thing. I don't know.
Mm. Oh, yeah. That made me wonder. Where... We know the town that they live in is called Peach Creek. I didn't search this. I don't know if it's a real place, but I wonder, where do you think, what state do you think they're in?
I don't know. Probably one with a lot of forests.
I was out there in Oklahoma. Oh, God, look what they're doing to Sarah.
I was thinking more like Oregon.
Maybe.
What did they do to him?
This is like the episode on when they were giving tours on that tire swing and the Kankers had like a ship.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Ew. Oh, God. I think my foot fetish went away. I'm only joking.
Excuse you?
Is she eating the croissant?
Yeah.
She uses actual paint as toenail polish?
Yeah. Oh! Ouch. Oh!
I like how they're using actual intelligence. Except for
Yeah.
the Eds. Is that a slingshot? I need to find my slingshot now. I want to go find it. I used to shoot it at my neighbors.
Jimmy's arm should be broken.
Well, remember, we all figured out they're Mr. Fantastic.
True. They all are.
It's like they're playing tag.
Yeah. There's Johnny.
Oh,
it
there he
looks
is.
Like he's not even out of the cul-de-sac yet.
Yeah, look, he just got to the town.
Yeah.
Is that a grappling hook? No.
Dude. Are you going to mail yourself or what?
That kind of would be smart, but then you have to wait for shipping and packaging.
True. It would be funny if Johnny knew where Eddie's brother lived.
We've established that Johnny's in there. I like how he came to the candy store. Actually, I remember...
I think Plank is, well, I know he's just a piece of wood, but I think Johnny is intelligent, and he's doing it through Plank.
Yeah. Like, Plank is speaking through Johnny.
Yeah.
That's what I always thought. But this is what the guy about the purgatory thing was saying. Even in the movie, even if they leave frickin' the cul-de-sac, everywhere else they go is in their imagination. Because when you see Johnny seen in the town, it's clearly empty.
Yeah, wouldn't adults be looking and wanting to help that poor boy?
You would think, because he was in the middle of a store. Oh, okay, we're back with Kevin and Nat. See, they're always a step behind.
Yeah. Was that a baby noise?
Probably.
Oh, my.
I mean, you gotta think about it. Naz wasn't in that many episodes of the show, and she... the thing is, she didn't have that much character development, to be honest.
Yeah, she was just the hot girl.
Yeah, I like how in the movie, they had all the characters actually play a role.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh!
Double D, really?
I'm waiting for Eddy to leave a clue behind.
Yeah. Jeez, is...
Oh, God. Kevin looks so confused.
I think Naz might grow up to be like a stripper or something.
I think...
With the way she's acting now.
I think Naz hit puberty early.
Yeah. And Eddy, I mean, and Kevin has no idea what's going on.
Even in the early episodes, he obviously shows that he likes... Oh, God. He obviously shows that he likes Naz. And yet, he's acting completely retarded.
Yes. Yes, well, wouldn't he be trying to protect Naz? I mean, normally, in the episodes...
Wait. He was strong enough to break through a locked door, but not lift up that switch.
Yeah. Oh, come on, it's just a bike. You can buy another one. Bike's replaceable, Naz isn't.
Oh my God, I love this.
Yeah. Did he just make a screwdriver out of a piece of wood?
It's Double D. I'd be surprised if he made a TV out of paper. Wait, what the hell?
Double D kind of reminds me of the professor off of Gilligan's Island.
I remember him. It's like, you're the smartest man you could ever think of, but you couldn't build a boat.
Yeah, except Double D can build a boat.
I imagine when I was a kid, I thought that nose was Plank.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, God.
Now, what I don't get... Yeah, that's what I never got in Gilligan's Island.
Look, he clearly had hair on the back of his head.
Yeah, and I seriously think that in Gilligan's Island, the professor... made like a radio out of a coconut, but he couldn't make a boat.
I remember that.
I'm like, you can make a radio out of a coconut, but you cannot make a boat.
Did you know there was a show called Gilligan's Planet?
Oh, good lord. What was that about?
No joke. Instead of building a boat to get off the island, they built a spaceship out of wood and coconut shavings.
Orbit.
And they went to a whole planet. Yep.
I'm like, I would have been like, wait, if you could do that, why didn't you make a boat?
Or a plane.
Or if you're so close to Hawaii, like everyone's saying, just swim.
You really want to get eaten by a shark?
Better than staying on that island.
Mm. He's going to feed us.
But I always wondered how close they were actually to Hawaii, since everybody kept going there.
Did he move the Earth?
Yep.
I like how they...
The new Avengers, people.
The new Avengers. No, the Eds would be the Defenders.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think, who would the Eds be if this was a superhero world?
I don't know. They would probably be supervillains, but end up being heroes.
They're anti-heroes?
Yeah. Hmm. Yeah.
Oh my god. That's horrifying.
Don't, Jimmy, don't. It's just a ladybug.
And Sarah's like, shut up.
Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh.
Uh-oh.
I swear, she has, like, super senses.
Yeah, no, wait, if they're, like, if they like them, why are they being mean to Sarah since...
They know that, well, they know who Sarah and the others are. They know that Sarah hates Ed, and that's why they treat her like that.
Oh, but I mean, Ed loves his sister, though, doesn't he?
Yeah, for some odd reason.
Yeah, and, I think the girl would happen to be nice to Sarah because Ed probably wouldn't like them.
Then again, you forget, the Eds don't like the girls, period, yet they can't take the hint.
True.
It is past the factory.
Yeah, well, no one knows where Rolf is.
The bus showed up.
They don't even show us the bus driver.
No, they don't show you anybody.
Yeah, it could be a demon for all we know.
I imagine it's a ghost driving. That's why Johnny was so confused. Oh, God, people.
Huh.
Notice how they don't react to him bumping into them.
If this was normal, they would probably be either yelling at him or asking him if he was okay since he's a kid.
Yep. Okay, one, why were all the adults on the back of the bus? Two, there is a lot of adults on this bus. And three, this doesn't even look like a bus anymore. It looks like they're on the Stark Market floor.
Yeah.
Oh my god, how big is this bus?
I don't know. What? Where's
the
bus driver?
Wait, what? Vengeance?
They're gonna die.
Wait, there are cars?
Yep.
There's a whole city? Wait, what? I want a whole new season now with them in that city.
Yeah. Look, it's like one of those drinking birds. Where's Ed?
I was about to ask the same question. Is he wearing a do-rag?
I guess. I think that was his shirt.
I know, but I'm just saying, he turned into a do-rag.
Yeah. There's Ed.
Is he slurping the swamp?
Ed, that is not chocolate.
He said it was gravy.
Yeah. That is not gravy.
Double D is right in this case. Ed and Eddy are acting completely crazy, even though... They're being chased. Yet they're doing all this.
Yeah, I think they're acting more crazier than normal.
Look at him. He's so confused.
I think he's wondering, why do I hang out with these two?
I think he asks himself that question every day.
Yeah.
This reminds me, there's that... Are they in quicksand? They are in quicksand. I would leave him there and be like, "Are you gonna be nice to me now?" How's that quicksand in the States?
I don't know. Maybe they're in the Amazon or something.
The Amazon. He's dead.
Dude, just go in and grab him. If you hardly make any moves, you won't sink. There it is. No, in quicksand, if you hardly ever move, you don't sink.
True. People panic too much, though.
See? Oh, no. They're gonna come up, aren't they?
You know they can't kill them.
Yeah.
If you didn't leave the cul-de-sac, you'd be dead.
Yeah.
Is that a peppermint on there?
Yeah. How did...
Their faces! They're insane. His face! He just walks off. He's pissed.
I think Double D has had enough of this.
He has. He's pissed.
Yeah.
He just doesn't care anymore.
Yeah, he even got himself dirty because he's so angry.
Oh. How many times are they face planning this show? Gosh.
Is he going home?
I think so. Yeah, he is.
Jeez.
Jesus. Eddie's trying not to laugh. I swear, he's in an ass.
Does Double D scare you when he's angry?
Yes. It reminds me of that episode where he accidentally beats up Lee and everyone becomes scared of him.
Yeah.
Oh, they talk about it. The red button?
Why would you put a red button on it?
They're actually fighting now.
Ed has no idea what's going on,
no,
does he?
No, he has no clue. Ooh, very agile fight. See, there's actual character development in this. I imagine he's like pissed because of this happening for years. And this was just the last straw.
Oh. Eddie is actually crying?
No.
What?
Wait.
Double D is like, what? Was Eddie just humble?
I told you this movie finishes the show. So, yes.
Yeah. Yeah, true. Oh!
Salt deposits. Damn.
I don't think they ever stopped. You guys ever stopped being friends. He was just ticked off.
Actually, they wouldn't be able to do anything without him.
Yeah.
Wait, where did...
Technically, they wouldn't be in this mess if he wasn't in the group.
No, they probably still would be.
True, but...
Oh, now they made it to the swamp. Kevin and that stupid bike.
Yeah. I think Naz is going to be ticked off at him next.
I imagine Naz punching him in the face.
Oh!
Ooh, you can see the handprint.
Oh, now it's actually turning into night.
Don't. Don't say anything, Kevin, if you value your life.
He has no idea what's going on. He's like Peter Parker when it comes to girls. He has no idea.
Yeah. Whoa! How what? Did that even happen?
We don't question it.
True. It actually cleaned them, too.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
He had that coming. He had that coming. Oh, God.
This is just a dream, isn't it?
I have no idea. I can't remember.
What's going on?
I have no idea.
Okay, now he's gonna die. Not the bike, not the bike.
Oh my God. Oh yes. Yes.
Does he think of Naz as a girlfriend or as a friend?
I think he thinks her as a friend. No, this is how I think of it. Because, like, I'm obviously a dude. And I'm kind of stupid. I can't tell if a chick is into me or not. I imagine it's like that. He has no idea that Naz is into him. And he just thinks of her as a friend. But she wants
He seemed to be into her at one time, though.
Yeah, I've said that. But I'm just saying, I think he has no idea.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Rolf is not having a good day.
No, he's not. And he's still stuck in that meat grinder.
Oh, no.
Wait, is that Johnny's bus?
Probably.
How is he not... Wait, it's not the bus? Uh-oh. Oh, God.
Run. Run.
Even Rolf scared.
Yeah, nothing can scare him.
Remember that one episode when it was Rolf and the Rangers got sent to the Kankers' house, and the Kankers ended up taking them over and made them into slaves?
Yep.
So yeah, most it's only been one day, because it's now turning to night.
Yes, and their parents would probably be worried by now.
I imagine their parents, like, don't come home often, so they have no idea what their kids are doing.
True, but someone has to be there to take care of them. I mean, they're only 13.
Yeah. I was left at home alone when I was 13.
Not all day, probably.
Hmm. I mean, I gotta move out soon. I already got a mini fridge and stuff like that already.
I just have a messy two-bedroom apartment that I share with my roommate.
At least you get to live on your own.
True. Oh.
Well, they did defy gravity? Well, I'm surprised.
Look at Eddie's face.
I just saw it. I'm going to watch the SpongeBob movie now.
Yeah.
We'll have to do that next weekend or like tomorrow or something.
Yep. That kind of looks like a grave.
Yeah. You didn't hear the dumbbells it was supposed to be?
Yeah.
Like, with college coming up, I made sure that my classes weren't, like, too booked. So I have, like, a clear time during the afternoon to record new stuff.
Yeah. Is YouTube, like, your job?
I do this as a hobby, actually.
Oh, okay.
You can make money off of this, but I recommend you don't do that until, like, years later, because you would need way more subscribers.
He's figuring it out. Yep. Yeah. He's figuring it out, isn't he?
Yep. He's labeling the freaking island. You'd probably break your back if you slept on that rock.
Yeah. Oh.
I expected him to get a hernia.
Yeah.
Wait, how do you label the ground like 1,800 times?
I don't know. It's Ed and Eddy. Don't question it.
Good point. Okay, now we're in the next day.
Yeah. My parents would have called the cops by now.
True.
I don't think they're mad anymore. I think they're just tired, don't you?
Yeah. Oh, God.
Was that really Eddy?
No. No way. Eddie's way further than they... Wait.
Yeah. Oh, no.
I was about to say, it's not Eddy. I knew it wasn't.
Yeah.
I was about to say, Eddie's way further.
How did his bike get fixed?
Ooh!
Never mind.
That was a good plan.
Yeah.
See, so the canker's just essentially capturing everybody.
So that they don't get to Ed, Ed, and Eddy?
Yeah, that's the whole point of them being here.
Yeah. Oh, good God.
Oh, this... I imagine they need a shower after that.
Yeah.
My question is, how do they even end up in that position?
I don't know.
That's my question.
Yeah. And Ed is still asleep. Oh!
We've seen Ed sleep through worse. Is it cause an earthquake?
I don't know.
Oh, Jesus Christ, the earth!
Yeah.
Wait, where'd those rocks come from?
That was his stomach?
They sound like bongo drums.
Yeah, but I mean, his stomach caused that earthquake.
Well, we saw Ed lift the whole sewer grate before.
True.
Jesus Christ, look at Eddie.
Oh! Those were the only hairs he had.
How do they get hurt?
Yet they're still...
They regrew. That is true. They haven't eaten all day.
Yeah.
Oh.
What is this, Looney Tunes now?
There was that one episode where Ed was actually standing on a cliff, and he's like, I can... He tries to jump it, and he's actually standing in midair.
And then he looks down and falls. No, like in Looney Tunes.
No, he doesn't fall. He actually just stays there, and he tries to jump. They grab him and pull him back over the edge. Yeah, he never falls.
Okay,
that would be fun.
Okay, now where are they? I mean, it looks like they're on a beachside with, like a
in the plot,
pier or something.
In the plot, they say that, remember that freaking cart that Eddy had?
Oh yeah, Monte La Gogo.
Yeah, that's where they ended up.
Yeah.
I feel like the park's closed.
Yeah, it's probably the off season.
This is clearly supposed to be during the summer, so.
Yeah.
Is there a ticket on that corn dog? Oh god.
Yeah.
How does he not have food
and
poisoning?
And some gum. It's Ed. He's eaten worse.
True. This is the same man who carries a tub of entire tub of gravy in his room. Remember that one episode when they got his ID and they found out his middle name was?
Yeah.
I can't remember what it was, though. I think it was like Sharon or something.
I thought it was like Cornelius or something.
No, it was like a girly name. I remember that.
Oh, yeah. Susan?
Oh, yeah, it was Susan.
Yeah.
But they still don't show his last name, though.
Yeah.
Oh, word.
Yeah, and I wonder if they're older, if one of them will go by their full name.
They would have to.
Like Ed, Ed, and Edward.
I imagine he called himself Edward. Look at Ed!
Who, Double D?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh!
Look at Ed! Ooh.
Yeah.
Oh, we're in the end. We're almost at the end. Sweet. Yeah.
Wow, it's been, we have 10 minutes left.
How does that work?
Oh no.
Where does she keep
Is
that?
he actually scared of their brother?
He wants to make a good impression.
Oh, okay.
I remember he used to wear that tie all throughout the school season.
Yep. Oh.
Look how far they... Oh. Oh, no, they're never in. They're close. I imagine they're not in a cul-de-sac anymore. They're just in that city you see that Johnny heads towards.
Yeah.
Look,
yeah, what if they have never actually left town?
This was the school in the background.
Yeah, I mean, what if they never actually left town and this was just, like, their whole town?
Oh, God, they caught up.
Oh, crud. Oh, crud. Oh! Oh, no.
I told you, they got all of them.
Yeah. Where's Johnny?
They never... Remember, Johnny's on the bus. They never saw him.
Oh, yeah.
What are you... They're scared of them.
They are really scared.
True.
I thought Rolf was knocked out.
Oh, God, now they showed up. That is retarded. See, she
Oh, come on, she's...
That's the whole reason she came, so she can beat him up.
She's so...
Eddie's like,
she's so malicious to her older brother.
I love Eddie's face there. He's like, wait a minute. My brother's here.
Yeah.
All right, the official reveal of Eddie's brother. Are you ready?
Yes. Yes.
They're all scared.
Uh-oh.
Here we go.
Uh-oh. They are so terrified.
Look at the sunglasses he's wearing. There he is. There he is.
He looks just like a grown-up version of Eddie.
That's what he's meant to be.
Yep.
Now you're going to see why Eddie's just an ass. Oh, my God.
And he fainted.
Yeah. Because he's like a legend among all the neighborhood kids.
Yeah.
Ooh.
No, that was just mean.
He's bro loose. I love how everybody else is just standing around doing nothing.
Well, if he was the legend he's supposed to be, wouldn't they be running like heck?
They can't. They're still tied up. Oh, now yeah. They're trying to run.
Yeah.
See, now they're not trying to chase him anymore.
Uh-oh. Oh, he's an ass.
Now you see why Eddie's the way he is. He gets it from him.
If he had a nice brother, I wonder how he would be.
Probably like probably a better person.
Like Double D?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh.
See? Ooh! He's throwing like he's a basketball.
And now the others want to help him?
Yeah, they understand now why Eddie's the way he is.
Yeah.
They feel bad.
Yeah.
See?
Don't get involved, Double D.
Eddie worships him. That's why he's the way he is. His smile, he looks like the Joker.
Yeah. Oh! Come on, not Double D.
Where'd Double D go? I was about to say, where'd he go? Well, now they all care.
Yeah.
Rick and Rolf.
Yeah, because isn't Double D, like, the good one?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why they care.
They do feel bad for Eddy, too.
Yeah, true.
Guess who saves the day in the end?
Ed.
Yup, watch this.
Oh, that looks like it hurt.
Ooh. I literally have tears in my eyes because of how much I'm enjoying this.
Oh.
Ooh.
I think his brother just got a concussion.
I think Eddy had a concussion.
Yeah. I think they see that. So they don't want to beat him up anymore?
Look at Ed, he's trying to sacrifice himself.
No. They're not going after them. Were they that scared of his brother?
To the pit of victory.
Oh.
I remember that.
He got a kiss from Naz.
Better than what Kevin got, which was nothing.
Yeah.
They smacked him in the head with a door. That was awesome. Oh, God.
Oh no, the cakers have him.
He's like in his 20s, they're going to rape him. Oh, look, he just showed up.
Yeah.
You hear a heartbeat?
Are they going to try and beat Johnny up now?
It's Mammon time. Good question. Oh, I like how we got all of them at once.
Oh!
Yeah!
Oh, now they're going after him!
See, they're not afraid to beat up Johnny!
Yeah!
They wrecked him!
That's how the show wait, ends. What?
They're all friends now.
Yeah. Yeah, but, Johnny probably has no idea what's going on.
I like that scene where he, like, mentions all the episodes.
Yep.
I love how they ended with that song, too. Oh, God!
Uh-oh.
They're dragging him to the love shack.
Yeah.
Now they ain't gonna mess with the Eds in the morning, either.
No, because they have a bigger version of Eddy.
Yeah.
That was a great movie.
If you keep watching, we get an end credit scene.
Yeah, I am too.
Apparently, this is a Marvel movie.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
That's why I love this movie so much.
Oh.
I'm kind of sad that freaking,
Yeah. If you were there, would you have beaten up, Eddie's brother, too?
Listen to what Johnny says.
Yeah.
He turned the Joker.
I think Johnny went crazy.
He's turning to a villain. Listen what he says.
Yeah.
Just listen, listen, listen. Wait for it. Okay, here it is.
But that would have been a great movie just with Johnny taking over, trying to take over the cul-de-sac.
Yeah, I imagine another season like that.
Yeah.
Well, then again, I don't... Yeah, I think there probably couldn't have been another one, because the whole point of the show was the kids beating up the Edge for, like, the pranks they did. If there was no conflict with the kids, well, the show would have been out.
Maybe they
you really want to add could all beat new characters? Up
different kids, or the Eds could do different kids. Yeah. And the original characters could help the Eds with the pranks or the scams.
A hazing.
It's kind of like a hazing to the new people who move into the cul-de-sac.
That was fun.
Yeah.
See, this is how most of the show is going to be. It's just more interesting when we have more people.
Yeah.
I don't even know. I have to watch this now because most of the time I'll just be laughing.
And who knows, maybe we could react to, like, funny YouTube videos as well.